All right, today I'm going to show you how to remove the power brake booster and disassemble it, rebuild it, and reassemble it. One of the first things we want to do is remove this brace right here. We got two bolts here, two up there. Need to get that brace out of the way so then we can get to the master cylinder. We'll be removing the wires from the brake switch and disconnecting the bolts from the power brake booster. We'll be removing these two hoses off of there also. Then we'll go inside and remove the C-clamp and the bolts from inside, and it should just pop on out. Alright, we got the brace off. We've disconnected the wires and loosened up the bolts over here on the master cylinder. We're just kind of backed it off nice and slow. We're just going to back it off a little bit, remove it. Hear that air? There's a little bit of air still in there. Alright, we got that disc pushed back a little bit out of the way, and we've got the hoses disconnected, so now we are going to head on into the compartment and remove what we need to do in there. Alright, this is a little difficult to film, but we have a C-clamp right here that needs to come out. And then if you look in the back there, you see a couple of bolts. That's what's holding the power brake booster. And we get that C-clamp out and disconnect that rod. And there's four of those bolts back there that need to come out. And then it should just slide on out through the engine compartment. All right, we got the seat clamp off in there. We slid the rod off the pin that the seat clamp was attached to. Got the four bolts that were holding the power brake booster in, and so now what we're gonna do is pull it out. All right, just make sure that the master cylinder is pulled back a little bit. Be careful because of your tubing, you don't want to mess that up, but just get it back far enough so you can slide it out. I'm gonna go ahead and pull this off of here, and look at that. And there you have it. All right. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this on the workbench, and we'll get started on it. All right. So we got it on the workbench here, and kind of looking around in there, it's pretty corroded. A while back I had a master cylinder go out that was leaking, and I bet that's probably what caused it. I bet your fluid probably got in there and messed up the rubber, plus it's kind of old. There's the push rod linkage there. This is where the rod went through, a little short rod that went through, and it had a C-clamp on it. And there's a plunger. It's rubber. I mean, it feels pretty oily, so I'm guessing it just got messed up by the oil. Plus, it's, you know, old age. Who knows? I can't remember when the last time it was rebuilt. So what we're going to do is we're going to remove all these screws and take it apart. go. I'm gonna go ahead and take this off. And on these screws, I would just kind of loosen them up a little bit, screw them back in, just make sure they're gonna come out all right. I'd probably leave about at least four of them in until you're getting ready to take it apart, and just take each one of those out. All right, I'm down to my final two screws here. Something to pry it out. Yeah, it's stuck in there pretty good. Let me grab something real quick, pull that apart. All right, we got a screwdriver here. Just take your time. Kind of go around the edge. This is the underneath part right here. It looks like something had been leaking up from under there. All right, let's see. Here we go. There we go. Yeah, we got fluid in there. That's not good. That's the back side of it. A lot of oil, a lot of brake fluid. So let's see, let's take a look at this. Oh, here we go. There's the problem. Look at that. That diaphragm got a hole in it. So let's take the rest of this apart. I think that rubber piece has got to come through. Yeah, there we go. Push that rubber piece through there. And there we go. A lot of fluid in there. See, it's pretty simple. But I'll pull out the kit so you can see what's involved with that. Okay, so this is what the kit, what comes in the kit. And it comes with these new rubber, rear rubber boot, some O-rings. Earlier I called that a C-clamp. It's a C retainer washer, I believe. I don't know what I was thinking earlier, but comes with a new check valve, which fits right in here. It's a little rubber check valve. Some new washers, copper washers for that. And the main thing is the diaphragm. To replace the old one. And let's see, we got that part right there, which is right here. So Should be able to just take it all apart and just replace what comes in the kit. I'm not sure if all of this is going to be used, but once I take it apart, we'll see. And the kit comes with a breakdown, so it kind of gives you an idea what goes where. But once you take it apart, you see what needs to come apart, and you just replace it with the new piece. There's a lot of oil in there, so all that oil is going to need to be cleaned out, because you don't want any oil in there. It'll just mess up that rubber again. So I'm going to go ahead and get started on it. All right, we're going to knock out this easy part right here. We got this rear seal and the rubber boot back here. This just pops off. And this rear seal should both pop off. Let's see if I can get that pushed down inside there. And you know, when you're taking something apart, you know, pay attention to what you're doing. As you see, very simple. You know, you got these parts, this edge here, exact same thing. Yeah, make sure you clean all the oil, if there was any oil inside there, get it all cleaned up. I went ahead and cleaned all the oil out of here, and I actually took a wire brush and get all that goop that was in there. So what we're going to do is stick that back inside there like that. Take a little coaching. Time, get that rubber piece all the way around there. There you go. You got that all in there. Make sure it's in that groove. There's a little rubber groove that's going to fit through. Make sure it's all pushed in there good. Also, try to make sure that you don't have any oil on your hands. I got a little bit on me, but not enough to cause a problem. I tried washing most of it, but just take an old shirt or something and wipe any oil on there. There's the rear rubber boot. That's gonna just fit right over that. Got that on, and that's done. And let's see, I'm gonna go ahead and go to the next phase. All right, so now we're gonna take the rest of it apart, the diaphragm. Filling the old one, it's hardened. That's hardened up pretty good compared to the new one here. It's pretty flexible. So what we got here now is we have a retainer spring inside there that's holding this piece in there. So we need to get that out. Now, when you take this retainer spring out, make sure you look at it, because the top part has a bevel on it. Back side of it is perfectly flat. That bevel is going to be on top. So let's take a look and see what we got here. Oh wow, that's a lot of goop in there. A lot of corrosion. Yeah, I'm gonna have to spend some time getting all that rust off of there before I assemble it back together. So there's the old diaphragm, and the new one. Okay, so I'm gonna put that aside. And all these pieces right here, they got some rust on it too, so I'm going to disassemble that. If you look right here, there's a little indicator right there, a little niche, and that's where that rubber is going to be. If you look at the new rubber piece, you see the little niche right there also. So that'll be fitting in there like that. And all these little pieces of metal, let me see if I can just go ahead and take it out. Yeah, we got a lot of goop down in there. There's the back side of it. It almost looks like somebody had put a layer of some kind of maybe O-ring fluid on it or something. But anyway, these are all going to come out. Let's see if we can get that out of there. You see this a little niche in there. Make sure you clean all that up, and it'll be fitting right back inside there. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn the camera off and try to clean all that up and reassemble it. Clean all that up too, and let's see what else we have here. I don't think everything they got in the kit is going to pertain to this particular booster, but there's an O-ring right here that'll be replaced with this new one. We got a little plastic piece here, which is that right there. So I'm going to go ahead and turn the camera off and get this all cleaned up. I got some of it cleaned up. There's all the metal pieces that went in that rubber piece. Got all the rust off of them. This piece right here was on the back side of this. It fit inside there like that. And so I got that cleaned up. So what we're going to do is just stick those back in inside these holes, get them all put in there. piece of metal, fit right inside there like that, and that'll be ready to be put back in there. Now this piece that came out of, it's got a little retainer piece here that needs to be pushed through. Get that out. It's almost like another seat. Now be careful with this because there's a spring on it and it's loaded. We'll put that right there. And here you go. Now we need to get that little plastic piece off of there. Okay. Now it just slides off of there. There's the little spring. And there's that part. That part is this, goes right here. Okay. Remember how it comes off. And if we look down in there, we have an O-ring right down in there. And let's see what else is down in there. There's the O-ring for that. So I'm going to go ahead and clean this up and get it put back together. Alright, so got that cleaned up a little bit now. And next thing we're going to do is, let's get this out of the way. Alright, so we got that. This is going to be replaced. We got the spring cleaned up. And this just slides out. When you pull this out, you're going to notice some grease in there. And what that is, it's silicone grease. And I would go ahead and leave as much as you can on that. If you need any more silicone grease, you can get this at Lowe's or Home Depot. It's usually in the plumbing department. Ace Hardware sometimes carries it. So what we're going to do now is go ahead and replace that O-ring, that O-ring, and this is a plunger seal right here. And so we'll go ahead and do that. So get your little screwdriver, pull that out of there. And there's that. There's the new one. Like I said, you're going to get a little bit of this silicone grease on it. So if you have some on there, it might even help slide it on better. So we're going to go ahead and get that put on there. Get a little screwdriver, get it back in that groove that it came out of. Careful not to cut the O-ring. So that one's done. We'll go to the next one. Alright. Matter of fact, I would probably suggest putting a little bit of grease on your fingers when you're putting that in there. Go ahead and put some on that O-ring. And there you go, got that one on there. Now pay attention to the plunger, how it comes off. This might be a little bit more difficult to get off, but I'm probably just gonna put back on. Alright, so when you see it coming off, you notice the shape of it. You want to make sure there's the back, there's the front. A little bit of grease on that. And slide it back on there. Thank you. but it's not twisted. It's a little twisted right there. All right. Okay, got that on there. I'm gonna go ahead and put a little bit more of this silicone grease on it. Coat it pretty good. And put some down in this part right here. And slide it back in there. Okay. Make sure it moves good. Looks like I got plenty of silicone grease on there. It has some inside there too. I think I'll put a little coat in there. Just a little bit extra. Alright, moves freely. So, got the spring. Let's see. Got to put this on first, then the spring, then this piece, and let's see, get this, got to make sure you push it down so you can get to that groove. Let's see, if you push this in there. Put that clamp back on there. There it goes. Alright. Clamp is in there. All looks good. Looks good. And we'll put a new piece of plastic seal. I'm guessing it's a plastic seal. And then the back side, we got the other O-ring. Alright, get that old O-ring. We'll go ahead and put a little coat of silicone grease on that. And we'll push that, push it all the way around, it'll go right in that groove. Okay. So that's it. Now it seemed like there was a little bit of silicone grease on the back side of this, so I'm going to put a little coat of that on there. And that's where that piece of metal went on there. It's going to go in there. Now remember what I said about, I'm going to put a little coat of silicone grease around there so it slides in a little bit better. Alright. Little niche right there, little niche on that piece right there, fits right in there. Look at that, fit in there like a glove. Okay, and that's that. So that's the old stuff, didn't need that at all. It's old, old. This other stuff, I'm guessing that C retainer, that looks a little too small to go up under the, up in the, where the linkage is. Alright, so, got that all cleaned up. That's all cleaned up. It's gonna fit that. It's gonna fit in there like that. So, alright, so when you go to put this in here, got four grooves. These are going to fit on those four grooves. All right so I'm going to grab something because we got to put that back on there. And whoops, I'll go get that spring. Alright, so we got this. Remember now, this has a bevel on it. The bevel will be on top. Okay, so if you notice when it's laying on the table, that thing just wants to fall through because of that other side sticking out. So what I'm going to do is I got an old coffee can. Sit that on there like that. And make sure that's good. Okay. Alright. Let's see if I can get this thing to fit in there. Let me clean my hands a little bit before I put that in. Alright, so I got my hands cleaned. So it's going to probably be a little difficult getting that retainer in there because of this new O-ring. Because if we look down in there, it's going to take some pressure to get that flush. So let's see if I can do it. It's not going to take me too long. Alright. What I'd kind of do is probably squeeze it like this and try to feed it in that channel. Get discouraged. It may take a little while. Like I said, we've got a new O-ring in there. It may have a little trouble getting that thing in there. Turn the camera off and work on this. I don't want to bore you guys trying to get that spring in, but it's going to take a little time getting it in there, get it seated. Okay, so I finally got that retainer spring in there. It took a little time because of that new O-ring. It was a little higher, so it was a little difficult getting it in, but it's in there now. And I'm kind of just rubbing a little bit of that silicone, just a real light coat of that silicone on there. It's waterproof, just a real light coat, just kind of protect a little bit. And let's see, let's go ahead and get rid of this old diaphragm and parts, get all this stuff. That diaphragm, you can send it back to them and you'll get your core. I think it's $75. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and put it back. I decided not to use this rear boot. The reason why, it's taller than the other one and it doesn't have the accordion style like that. This doesn't seem to be anything wrong with this one, so I'm going to reuse it. It just, when it plunges in there, the accordion is a lot better. So they really need to come up with one like this one if they can. All right, so let's get this out of the way. So that's all cleaned in there. Took an electric drill with a wire brush on it and cleaned it really good. And so this, I'm gonna put a little bit of silicone on this right here so it slides in and out of that rubber boot good. And we're gonna just slide that back in there. There we go. Alright. Then I'm gonna go ahead and get the front. There's the front. There it is. Alright. I think I'm gonna go ahead and do the check valve. Let's see if you can see the check valve here. That little rubber piece in there, you can see the back side of it. That just needs to be pushed through there. Again, I got this all cleaned up, got all the brake fluid out of it. So let's see. There's a check valve. Be able to just push that through there. The little rubber piece we're replacing. I'm going to go ahead and kind of wipe that off inside there. You want a good seal. Make sure there's no brake fluid in that hole. Looks good. Alright, so here's the new little rubber check valve. We're going to put that in there. Try to get it lined up. Fingers are almost too big to get it pushed in there. Come on. There we go. There's a little nipple part. You just, if you can get a hold of it, grab it, pull it through there, make sure it's seat. Looks like it's in there good. And let's see here. That's pretty tight. I'm gonna have to work on that before getting that apart. I don't know if that one's copper. Doesn't feel like copper. But I'm gonna leave that little bushing in there because it looks good. I'll put the copper on the other side. Wait a minute, what do we got here? This is another. Yeah, this is like a microfiber washer, which I'm gonna keep that too. I didn't get any leaks in it, so I'm gonna leave that the way it is. Okay, so remember how it goes, like that. And we got that rubber piece that we got to bring back through here. We may go ahead and put that in first. Let's see here. Try to get it started around there. And try to bring it through. All right, we got the rubber piece back in there. Make sure that it is in there centered. Okay. All right, so the diaphragm, we want to make sure that that's set in there right. Now you could actually hear the air pushing. We got that in there. And just make sure we got that top. That'll be the top. Almost need my coffee container again. Off of there, see if we can look down inside there, because we got to get that in, get that rubber boot in the back, or seal is what I'm trying to say. There it comes. I'm going to work around it. There it went. See, there's that pushing it come through the rubber seat. And we got, make sure the screw holes are gonna fit. It was lined up. I'm gonna go ahead and leave the rubber boot off for right now. Make sure that lined up. Putting those screws in there. That looks good. So I'm going to go ahead and turn the camera off while I get this screwed in. And that rubber, put the rubber boot back on there, and that'll slide in there like that. All right, so I'm going to turn the camera off and get those screws put in there. Okay, so got all the screws back in, and I'm going to go ahead and install it back in the car. And just reverse, you know, the way you took it off, just reverse it and put it, everything back the way it was, you know, just stick it in the firewall and go inside, bolt it up, make sure you get that that C retainer in there good, so it doesn't come apart on you as you're going down the road. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it back on the car, and I'll come back. All right, well, got it all back together. I just went on a test drive and everything's working great. No more you know, leak. There was a leak. You could hear the air escaping from that hole that was in the diaphragm. which was messing up the motor. Whenever you put the brake on, it would mess up the motor the way it was running. So now everything is running good and the brake is working. So hope this helps everybody who decides to rebuild their own brake power booster. I know there's not really many videos on the internet about doing it, and it's really something that used to be done years ago and people stopped rebuilding them. Let's see what else I was going to say. Just make sure your hands are clean. The diaphragm, you want to make sure there's no oil. Don't put any silicone grease on the diaphragm, and you should be good to go. Make sure everything's cleaned inside. No fluid, no power steering fluid or brake fluid, and you should be good to go. If it looks like it's going to be too much for you, just send it to someone that rebuilds them. Have a good day.